Medical doctors predicted I would never stop snoring, but contrary to their prediction, I was able to stop my snoring using 100% natural methods. And in this video, I am going to show you how you too can easily stop snoring and sleep apnea. Hello, my name is David, and I know what you are going through. I know that you have had enough of feeling exhausted because your snoring keeps waking you up every night, or maybe your snoring has affected past relationships, or it may be affecting the one you are in right now. Simply because your partner is refusing to sleep in the same room as you. You are sick and tired of the inconvenience of using a CPAP machine to minimize your sleep apnea, or you have shied away from staying over at someone's house or joining friends on outdoor group activities because you're so embarrassed about your snoring. Or you might have even considered a surgical procedure to correct your snoring or sleep apnea, but you are worried about the dangers. If this is the situation you might be finding yourself in, then this is the most important video you have ever came across. Because I am here to tell you that there is a solution. And not only that. But by using this easy method you will finally be able to sleep like a baby and enjoy a great night's sleep for the first time in years. You'll wake up refreshed and energized every morning, eager to start the day. You will be able to transform your relationships with the opposite sex. You'll finally be able to enjoy sleeping in the same bed as your partner or spouse without getting any complaints when you wake up. You will say goodbye to useless nasal strips, mouth guards and throat sprays, which rarely work, and only succeed in lightening your wallet, not improving your sleep. You will ditch that expensive and uncomfortable CPAP machine for good. Those things are supposed to help you sleep better, but they're so uncomfortable to wear and can even make the situation worse. But before I share with you my secret, let me tell you a little story about myself. I used to snore like a chainsaw for years, and it was so bad that it wrecked my marriage. According to my mom, I snored from my early teens. And it was very loud. My own parents had to wear earplugs to drown out the noise, and they were two rooms down from me. When I was 14, me and a bunch of friends stayed over at a friend's house. The following morning, everyone was angry at me because I had kept them all awake with my snoring. And to make matters worse, they started making fun of me. In the space of a day, the entire school knew that I snored like a chainsaw. Consequently, my entire childhood was plagued by being too embarrassed to have sleepovers, go camping with my friends, or do anything that meant sleeping the night in the same room or house as other people. This situation continued into adulthood. If I'd meet a girl, I was afraid to stay the night because I felt that as soon as she heard how loud my snoring was, she wouldn't want to be with me anymore. So for years, I stayed single. But then at the age of 27, I met an amazing woman called Deborah. She was incredible, the kind of girl that lit up a room when she walked into it. From the moment I met her, I was madly, deeply in love. And so was she. It was a whirlwind romance and we were married within months. But after just 8 weeks of marriage, I woke up one night to find her crying. I asked her what was wrong, and she said that although she loved me dearly, she couldn't take the snoring any longer. Her performance at work was being affected because she was constantly tired, and could barely think straight anymore. I felt terrible, and agreed to sleep in the spare room. But about a year into the marriage, I saw her crying again. When I asked her what was wrong, she sat me down and said she had something to confess. She explained that sleeping in separate bedrooms, and the lack of intimacy that went with it, bothered her a lot. She told me that she didn't feel as close to me anymore, that my snoring had driven a wedge between us. We'd become flatmates, rather than husband and wife, and then she hit me with a bombshell. She was seeing somebody else. The next day, Deborah moved out and filed for divorce. I was consumed with depression, and angry that my snoring had resulted in me losing the woman I loved. I thought that if I couldn't find a way to stop my snoring problem, I'd be single for the rest of my life. But it wasn't just the snoring that was ruining my life. In the past, Deborah had told me that I'd wake up several times a night with a kind of pig snort or choking sound. I didn't really realize what it was, or how potentially serious it could be. But as the years went by, I was starting to feel completely exhausted, which meant I found it more and more difficult to focus at work. What's more, years of not getting enough sleep was taking its toll on my health. I was putting on weight, and forever picking up colds and viruses, and the constant fatigue had left me feeling very depressed. After seeing my doctor about it a number of times, I was eventually referred to a sleep clinic where I was told that I'd developed a potentially life-threatening condition known as obstructive sleep apnea, OSA. For those who don't know, Sleep apnea is a serious sleep disorder that occurs when a person's breathing is interrupted during sleep. Apparently, people with untreated sleep apnea stop breathing repeatedly during their sleep, which can last from a few seconds to more than a minute, and this can occur literally hundreds of times during the course of a night. This means the brain, and the rest of the body, isn't getting enough oxygen. People who suffer from sleep apnea often have only around 60% of the necessary oxygen content in their blood. And if your vital organs aren't getting enough oxygen, it can lead to a number of dangerous and potentially fatal health conditions, including high blood pressure, poor concentration and memory, diabetes, depression, headaches, and many others. There are two types of sleep apnea. Type number 1, obstructive sleep apnea, OSA, which is the more common of the two forms of sleep apnea, and is caused by a blockage of the airway, usually when the soft tissue in the back of the throat collapses during sleep. Type number 2, central sleep apnea, CSA. Unlike OSA, the airway is not blocked, but the brain fails to signal the muscles to breathe, due to instability in the respiratory control center. Now it all made sense. This was the reason I was feeling so tired all the time. I wasn't just snoring myself awake. I was literally stopping breathing multiple times throughout the night, and subsequently my brain wasn't getting enough oxygen to feed all of my vital organs. It was no wonder I was struggling to focus at work, having lapses in memory and feeling completely exhausted at the end of every day. After I was diagnosed with sleep apnea, my doctor recommended a CPAP machine. If you're not aware of these things, they work by continuously blowing air into the throat at a slightly higher pressure than normal. This higher pressure acts to hold airways open, thus preventing oxygen deprivation in sleep. But there are five big problems with the CPAP machine. 1. It doesn't cure the underlying cause of your sleep apnea. It only treats the major symptom. 2. They're expensive. CPAP machines cost anywhere from $200 for a really cheap one that probably won't do much to $4,000 plus for a top-of-the-range model. 3. They're incredibly uncomfortable to wear. It's a weird feeling breathing into these things. It's like scuba diving and it's not nice or relaxing. 4. They're noisy. If you're lucky enough to get to sleep with one of these on, your partner probably won't. 5. You'll look ridiculous. Trust me, you'll never be able to hold down a relationship with a crazy-looking alien-like mask on your face. The next option I looked into was a surgical procedure. But there were two massive problems with this one. 1. It's hugely expensive and, 2. There are no guarantees it will even work. Everything I read kept telling me that there was no guarantee it would cure my problems. And even if it did work, my snoring and sleep apnea could easily return after a few months. So I had already wasted huge amounts of money and time on mouth guards, nasal strips, sprays and an expensive, stupid-looking and uncomfortable CPAP machine which didn't even work. I then decided that I needed to start thinking outside the box. I began to look into natural remedies. I researched these for many years. I visited practically every website and forum there was on snoring and sleep apnea, and read every book there was on the subject. I tried dozens of different methods, including some unconventional ones, in the hope that I'd eventually find something that works. And finally I did find the solution. I discovered an incredibly effective way to stop my snoring and sleep apnea. And my sleep apnea, which had been such a massive problem for me before, didn't seem to be disturbing me anymore. I was breathing properly and sleeping soundly through the night. For the first time in years, I woke up feeling refreshed and energized. And the best part was, I did it 100% naturally, without blowing loads of cash, and without any costly or dangerous surgical procedures. I conquered my snoring and sleep apnea, and now I want to share my secret with you. And the benefits of this method is that it's an easy-to-follow all-natural treatment plan proven to combat snoring and sleep apnea to give you an uninterrupted and restful night's sleep. These remedies will have you sleeping like a baby and as silent as a mouse. There is no need for drugs, surgery, nor wasting money on useless mouth guards, nasal strips, sprays or expensive medical equipment. I will show you the biggest danger signs and how to spot them, so you can take action before this debilitating condition causes any more damage to your health and life expectancy. I am also sharing revolutionary exercises, scientifically proven to treat snoring and sleep apnea. These exercises can be performed at home, at work, in the car, or before you go to bed, and require just 3 minutes a day. Also, you will learn about herbal remedies that are proven to combat sleep apnea for good. Instead of expensive drugs and dangerous surgery, I reveal how these six ancient Ayurvedic remedies have helped put an end to sleep apnea for thousands of people all over the world. And because I genuinely want to help you. Having been a snorer for most of my life, and suffered from the debilitating and worrying symptoms of sleep apnea too, I know how much of a problem it can be. I know what it's like to feel constantly exhausted, to suffer the embarrassment of keeping people awake, and to lose someone you love because they simply can't take it anymore. I know what it's like to feel like you're being punished unfairly, and to experience that sense of hopelessness, frustration and anger at not being able to fix the problem, however many stop snoring products you buy or doctors you see. Believe me, I've been there. I know exactly what you're going through. And I don't want you to feel like this any longer. And because of that, I am inviting you to click the link below this video to visit my official website to check out what other people are saying about my discovery.